Carroll, you picked a great car in the Ford Fusion. Look, for 2017, they redesigned the vehicle. They redesigned it totally. If you notice, the hood actually has a little bit more of a dome. They moved the fog lights out a little bit to give it a sleeker look. Now, Ford put a whole lot of emphasis in it. Also, not just the outside, but in the engine. The vehicle has two new engines in it. You also, you have a 1.0 liter EcoBoost engine, a 2.7 liter EcoBoost, a 1.5 EcoBoost, as well as a 2.5 liter four cylinder engine. So what that does is it gives you a range of engines, a range of power on it. Now, the EcoBoost engine has an auto stop feature that helps maximize your fuel economy. Because what it does is when you come to a red light, it'll actually turn off for you to help conserve fuel. Now, speaking of that, the vehicle is also available in two different hybrid models. There's a regular hybrid model that actually gives you regenerative braking and a battery pack to conserve fuel, and also a plug-in hybrid called the Energy that can run purely on nothing but electricity. Now, for 2017, you have the SE, the titanium, but Ford also added a sport model and a platinum for folks who like a car with a little bit more luxury, you know? Come on around, I want to show you something over here. As you look inside, don't be alarmed because you don't see a gear shifter. What Ford has done is they've gone to a rotary shifter, which makes shifting easier and also a little bit more fun for you. Of course, I know you told me you have two kids, so safety is important for you. Now, of course, like everybody else, Ford has side curtain airbags as well as front airbags, but Ford has actually put in a number of safety features to help you avoid an accident altogether. One is it's called a pedestrian. It's a collision avoidance system with pedestrian alert. It uses radars from the front and also a camera that help you know if there's anything coming in your path, but also it can control your brakes to actually slow you down or even stop you to prevent a collision. And come around, I want you to take a look at some stuff on the inside. Come on, man, hop on in the front seat. I'm gonna get in and show you some things in here. Now, talking about the accident avoidance, the vehicle is also equipped with, is also available with an adaptive cruise function. Now, what adaptive cruise does for you is it allows you to set your cruise like normal, but however, if a vehicle were to come over, you're going 70 miles an hour, a vehicle comes over in front of you, you can set a gap. So if you want to stay one car behind, two cars behind, you can actually make sure you stay that far behind. And it also has a stop feature, so if that vehicle in front of you stops, it'll stop your car, and then once they start back moving, it'll speed you back up to your normal speed. Now, as you take a look here, Sync is nothing new to Ford, but for 2017, this vehicle has a Sync 3 system. What Ford did was they improved it. Number one, you can do all your updates through Wi-Fi. Number two, the screen is different. It's a little bit easier to read and also recognizes voice commands a little bit better for you. Now, in addition to that, you have the Sync Connect and Ford Pass app. Combining those two, you can actually find your vehicle. Actually, it'll give you your location, tell you how much fuel is in your car, as well as tell you how many miles are on it. And the coolest thing is this, you can program a remote start. So say, for instance, you get off work at 5 o'clock. You want your vehicle to start up at 4:45 to start cooling down. So you can program it to actually be running when you get outside to maximize your cooling inside the vehicle. Pretty neat, isn't it?
Very much so.
You know, everybody uses their phones in their cars. The vehicle is compatible with the Apple Play system as well as the Android Auto, and that allows you to get better connectivity as far as making phone calls, listen to your voicemail. But also, you take a vehicle that doesn't have navigation, and you can actually reach into your Google, you can use your Google Maps or your Apple Maps to actually give you navigation the car that's not equipped with. Yes, ma'am. Hey, and this market is very competitive. Right next door to us is Richard's Honda. A lot of people compare the Fusion with the Honda Accord.
I was actually looking at the Accord.
Yes, ma'am. But let me tell you, the Ford outsmarts the Accord because our blind spot monitoring system actually monitors both sides, whereas the Honda only monitors one side. Also, the adaptive cruise program that we have in the Fusion is not even available on the Accord. Now, I tell you what, we're going to take a walk over because you mentioned Escape as well. Come on, we're going to take a look at the Escape. Now, the Ford Escape was redesigned for 2017 as well. If you look up front, the grille is different. Also, you have the bigger Ford emblem, which just makes it look more aggressive. And as you come along the sides, you'll notice more defined lines starting from the front all the way back to your rear hatch. As we come around the back, I'm gonna show you the back hatch. Before it added two engines in the vehicle, now there's a 1.0, there's a 1.5 liter EcoBoost and a 2.5 liter EcoBoost engine that they put with the same auto stop like I told you about on the Fusion. That will actually stop, and I actually turn the vehicle off at a red light to conserve fuel. And there's a 2.5 liter four cylinder engine. Properly equipped, the vehicle will torque to 3,500 pounds. And for folks who are a little bit more adventurous, it has an intelligent four-wheel drive system that actually controls the four-wheel drive, actually sending the power to the wheels that have the most grip. Now, ma'am, as you come around here, this particular vehicle is equipped with a cargo cover, but these back seats will fold down. They'll fold down deep to give you a taller cargo area, but then also fold down flat if you had a large item that you wanted to slide all the way in. Now, it's kind of warmer here, ma'am, so what I'm going to do is just let you take a look at some things on the inside of the vehicle, okay? Come on, have a seat.